March, for Pan's sake.
Where are all the flowers?
Hello?
Hello? Who's there?
Hi. I just moved here. Why are you in the woods?
I kind of live here. I should be asking you that question.
I moved. I was, mongering around the town to get a feel for the place. Got any friends in here, Tree Boy?
Tree Boy? So original. You can't answer your question, no, not except for the stupid flowers that are refusing to bloom.
Well, in that case, we have something in common. I have not talked to anyone since second grade. That was my age. That's 9 years.
Well, I haven't talked to another human since 1973, and that human was doing a lot more than hugging the trees. Exquisite tie dye.
1973? That was 46 years ago. How old are you?
I don't know. I stopped counting around 74. But I'm more of a spirit, I think. I don't know. My family's based in the orchard where that Deerbergs is now. Ugly building. Lovely flower arrangements. Anyways, where are you from?
Well, do you want the whole story? Or just where I'm from?
Well, seeing that I have all the time, seeing that I don't have to die for another millennia, but you don't have any friends to hang out with, so...
Ouch, Tree Boy. Hurt. At least I don't talk to flowers in my free time. I was born in Belleville, New Jersey, and as soon as I was old enough to handle it, we moved to Portland, Maine. And yes, before you ask, I've been to both Portland and Seattle and New York.
Hold on. That's 5 different cities? How old are you? 15? And you still have to do that schooling thing, right? That's a thing? School?
Yes. I'm 17, by the way. I'm homeschooled because I move around too much. And whenever we moved here, my mom thought it would be a brilliant idea to stay for the year. So I'm going to be starting my senior year at Edwardsville High School, the premier high school in Illinois.
Well, I don't suppose I ever got your name, Miss Cynical.
It's Josie. Josie Allen.
Nice to meet you, Josie. I'm Tyler, and frolicking wood nymphs don't need last names. You came back?
Of course, Tree Boy. I don't like talking to the girls in my class. And I forgot how much school sucked. And I'm in a class with all freshmen. Like, I had to take a geography class.
You mean you're in a classroom full of kids that are barely high schoolers and all you can think about is longboarding? You're so weird.
That's the guy who talks to flowers.
Okay, at least the flowers doesn't make stupid jokes about literally anything.
Yeah, human friends suck. They can talk, but they can also talk bad.
What do you mean?
Do you know why I move around so much? We were in Carson for a year, and we were gonna settle down there, finally. I had friends, and I had lots of them. Halfway through the year, they told the guy I like these awful lies about me. Long story short...
Like I said, I have all the time in the world. I don't die for another millennia, and it doesn't seem like you have any friends to be hanging out with, so...
Well, I guess people find me hard to swallow. Or that I'm too loud. Or that I'm just too absorbed in my head. So, it's hard to make friends. Anyway, they spread these things on Instagram. And they catfish people with my photos. And they did other stuff. Sure, it hurt, but they just wanted wanted attention. It got so bad that the school had to suggest a move for me.
You mean the school actually cared?
Yeah, after my mom called them several times. I stuck it out for 3 more months, and then we moved halfway across the country to Atlanta, Georgia.
I can't imagine the rest of the country. Or anything else through the woods, for this matter.
Wait, you mean you've never left here? Tree Boy, we gotta go on a road trip sometime!
Josie, I can't. I can't live here. I'm forced to wander these dwindling woods until eventually I die too. I'm the last wood nymph left in Erdsville.
So you're telling me if I move again, you can't come with?
You'd want me to?
Well, duh, Tree Boy. You're the only friend I have. It's not like I can make any more.
I'm sorry, Josie. I shouldn't have let you come back.
Why? I love talking to you.
Because I can't leave, and you'd have to come here and visit me all the time, and I'm not worth the hassle. You deserve to live your mortal life as normal as possible and not worry about some deadbeat wood nymph. It's not fair to you, and I can't put that on you.
Then don't worry about it. I know what I can handle. This, it isn't too much.
You didn't know I couldn't leave until 2 minutes ago.
It's fine. Trust me. Oh, dang. It's almost dark. I said I'd be home before sunset.
I guess I'll see you soon.
Of course. I really do love talking with you, Tree Boy.
Okay. We'll try not to make it 2 weeks this time, because I like talking to you too.
Deal.
There's no need for violence. What's wrong?
I'm leaving.
You just got here.
No, I'm serious. I'm leaving. Like, Illinois.
Right now?
The truck is loaded, the bags are packed. I can't do anything about it. I would have told you sooner. I'm sorry.
No, I understand. It's hard. It's hard to make time to come out here.
That's not it. I tried to fix it. I told my mom I made a good friend, but she didn't believe me. And we're off to Phoenix now. I mean, right now.
Well, I guess this is goodbye.
I don't want it to be.
It's okay, I understand. This is how it has to be. You'll leave, and just like everybody else, you'll forget about me. You'll make new friends, you'll move on.
No, I could never forget about you. You're the friend I've always dreamed for, I've always hoped for. All I could ask is that she'll never forget about me.
Josie, I could never forget about you.